see you.
I want to see the Alliance map. Hamtunscire, the last Saxon stronghold.
And very heavily guarded. King Alfred is preparing for war. You will meet tremendous resistance.
As will Alfred. Is Guthrum Jarl there with his army?
He is. He and Uba have gathered a sizable force and intend on launching an attack on Alfred soon. If we support their assault, England will fall to us. A pagan land where a multitude of gods may freely roam.
I will go to Hamtunscire and speak with Guthrum. Send word to our allies to gather in the Thames just outside the Shire.
I will. May the gods share in this, our final victory.
What is it?
Eivor, you must not go. You must not. The signs, the portents, they shout and wail. Your leaving will be our doom.
Speak clearly, Volker. What have you seen?
I have thrown the bones, I have stirred the offal of beasts, and in the rising steam I saw the end of it all! Though this battle you may win, this war you will not. Your foe will be your master, your hope will be your grief. This is fate. Our fate.
I thank you for this, Volker, but the yarns of fate are too frayed for me to follow now. I owe this fight to my friends and allies, and I will see it through.
Go then. With great care. But know that the home you leave will not be the home to which you return.
Now you pay for your sins!
Strange to see Norse and Saxon banners flying side by side. I should find Guthrum. Soma!
Eivor, you come at Guthrum's call. It is good to see you.
And you, Soma. There's an uneasy peace here. Both armies with their hackles up. Was blood spilled?
No. We took Werum without resistance. These Saxons accompany their lord as we stand beside Guthrum.
So this fort is not the sum of his ambitions. Guthrum's plan is to bring the Saxons to the table.
If he can win the peace without a fight, he will do so.
And how likely is that?
Just now they sit on their thumbs in the church, talking in circles. Come, I will take you to him.
Who is Guthrum meeting here? Is it Alfred?
That's right. The King of the West Saxons has agreed to negotiate. Seems we have him on the back foot.
Guthrum should be careful. Alfred speaks with Loki's tongue.
Guthrum is not a babe at teat, Eivor.
Nor is Alfred. If he has come, it is for his own advantage.
Then give us counsel. Stand by Guthrum, show our strength. The King of Hayseeds will soon be humbled, trust me.
We took this town as if it were a straw hole. Do not challenge me, Elf King.
Your show of swagger and strength has my attention, Guthrum. But we agreed on terms. What more do you want?
The crown of Wessex.
Wessex has a king, and that king has the backing of the Almighty. Yours is a fever dream, Dane.
Guthrum does not negotiate with oathbreakers, men whose words are only shadows of their thoughts.
Ah, Eivor. Our blunted tool returns, Lord.
I have given you all I care to. A Danegeld to leave Werum. You swore an oath upon the cross and that pagan hammer.
And when you scurry back to whatever shit-soaked hovel you crawled from, we will release your men.
Speak again, handmaid, and I will feed your tongue to Eivor's raven.
A fair trade. We already have your cock.
Are we done with this pissing contest? If Guthrum has given you his word, then he will honor it. We will leave this town.
You have one day. Do not test the king's patience further, or our men will return to Wareham with force.
And if you doubt my conviction, know that the Avon River near Ufentune runs red with the blood of your countrymen. Their commander, what did his men cry as he fell? Ula? Uba? Yes, that was it. Remember, you have taken my silver. In return, I expect your honor. I will await news of your retreat in Chippenham.
Uba dead? It cannot be! Gods, I will tear that Saxon skin from his bones if this is true!
Alfred hisses with a snake tongue, but he gains nothing from this lie.
When news of this spreads through the camp, no Saxon will survive the day.
You swore upon the cross.
Oh, I have no intention of cowing to that milksack. Now more than ever, I will take his throne and his head.
In Winchester, Alfred used me as a tool and cast me aside. So let the betrayer be betrayed. We'll burn this village to the ground. After that, we take care of Alfred.
Burn Wareham to the ground! Make it a Saxon pyre!
Destroy everything!
Their roofs to splinters, their bones!
The hell with you!
Every great Norse you send to Valhalla, I'll send 10 to your hell!
You won't burn Wareham, scum!
Jesus God, my lord!
Lord Jesus Christ, the king, help me stand against the filthy heathen threat!
Your god son has forsaken you, Saxon!
You have no honor, Dane! You will not steal our land!
It's too late, little man. Our gods have spoken with war and wit. This is our end now!
We have this!
Ha! My blood needs fire! After cooling in this sodden field!
You'll burn in hell, traitorous scum!
I will feast on your marrow in Valhalla!
This day. We should find Soma. This place is routed, Soma.
Good work. We leave now. There are forest ruins just east of here, along the road.
Come on, men! Move!
Stay awake!
refuse death?
Where's your king now, Saxons? Cowering like a mouse! Every soul we meet sent to their god! Let us keep moving!
The ruins are close! Keep moving!
More Saxons! Draw your weapons!
The ruins are close! Keep moving!
We can rest here a moment. Now, tell me what you know of that breaker of rings. Weak and wretched troll.
Alfred is a wily fox. He appears frail, but draws upon an inner strength. He will not be easy to oust.
Fury will fuel my army and my claim.
It will not be enough. You must find a weakness.
Yes, that is why I called you here. Do you balk at the opportunity to bury the Saxon king?
I must first hear a plan to balk at.
Alfred spoke of Chippenham, a squat hovel of sheep and peasants.
So why does he go there, and not to Winchester? Your scouts must know, they're the best in England.
A holiday feast, their Saxon Christ Mass. Alfred will warm his heels by the fire, while Uba lies cold in an English field.
I have called upon my allies to join us in this fight, but I must know where to send them. Is Chippenham our final prize?
It is. But I will need my men for the coming fight as well. The hostages Alfred took, if there is a chance to save them?
We will not lose more friends today. Where are they held?
A place further ahead through this forest. They call it Hampton Blockade.
Soma, ride north to the Thames and lead my allies south. They should be gathered by now.
I will.
Gather on the river passing Chippenham. The rest of you set up camp there. I called you Raven Feeder once. At Porchester, you are as hot-headed as Thor. You have become a true leader, Eivor.
There's much to come, Guthrum, before we can rest with mead in our hands and songs in our ears.
I will crush Alfred's skull with my bare hands if Uba is dead.
We cannot dwell on this, even if it's true. If you want the throne, only strategy will deliver it.
Oh, bloody wrath will steal it. I will follow this Alfred, hound his heels. Revenge burns within me.
A wise man once told me, we do not dash ourselves against hopeless courses. We arrive unexpected, strike swift.
You turn my words against me now.
I took them too hard in my darkest.
Damn flames!
I took them too hard in my darkest times, my friend.
And Sigurd? He is back with you?
My brother's story is a long one, and for another time. Ridding the land of a strong ruler will make Wessex harder to tame.
You almost sound like you respect him, Eivor.
I've come to understand the trials of leadership, Guthrum. It is hard not to when you cradle something as fragile as life within your hands.
This is the blockade. The hostages must be in these buildings. What is your plan?
We can tread quietly so as not to alert the guards. But I can raid this place in moments with my crew.
I will follow your lead.
Show me what lies ahead.
Demanded it.
We'll save them, Guthrum. Stay calm.
Do you think he kept his word? He swore he would not kill them.
I cannot say for certain. Just hope we find them soon. Can you see your men?
No, but we must keep looking.
Are you Guthrum's men?
Aye. Free us and we will fight by your side.
You are a good friend to me. Thank you.
Every Saxon who spat at me will die.
You will have your chance, but don't be foolhardy. Let your steps take you far from here to a camp near Tippenham.
Enough skulking! Saxons do not deserve compassion! I will wash my blade in their blood!
I told you Guthrum wouldn't leave us here to rot.
I'll have to try that myself.
You have my true thanks, friend.
Go to the camp near Chippenham. Find your countrymen there.
Good. We'll pay back the Saxons for the insults they heaped.
Guthrum, some of your men.
We will not be feasting in Odin's hall tonight, boys.
We'll raise a cup to you.
I need no thanks, Guthrum. Let us speak more when we are safely away.
Don't wander off, you lightwit!
We're safe here. You should join your people at the camp. Even a surprise takes preparation.
Your bravery, your leadership, Eivor. You wear it well. You have grown much since last we spoke.
You judged me fairly, Guthrum. Harsh, though your words were. But I do not make the same mistake twice.
How is your brother, Sigurd?
He lives, a changed man. But he is free of Fulke's torment. That at least was a deed well done.
Will this all be worth it in the end? Everything we have done? Everything we have sacrificed to win this land? Sometimes I dream of soothed black furrowed earth. And blood seeping from seedlings, poisoning our future.
We must believe our way of life will survive. Our fates are woven, but our deeds forge our destiny.
And so to our final battle. We will wait for you at the camp. Eivor, you made it unscathed.
They came from all over England.
I never thought it possible, Eivor, that you would rally Saxons and Norse under your black-feathered banner.
They see the tyranny of this elf king. He would crush them all under heel and plug their hearts with his god.
So what is the plan, Eivor?
When is their feast day?
A few nights from now, but their revelry has already begun. We should attack now.
That is unwise. Soldiers pace the paths of the village.
Then the night of the feast, under cover of darkness. That is when we will strike.
Uba will not have died in vain.
We await your instructions, Eivor.
I will greet my allies first.
Good. Come find us again when you are ready.
All is ready, and your allies have arrived. Speak to them if you like. I'll be here when you're done.
Do you believe the Saxon?
Giedrich, after Rochester, I was not sure you would come again.
I've chosen my side. It would sooner bet a hog than allow Alfred to pillage the land of love.
Guthrum will trample Alfred's ambitions like weeds in the dirt. Mercia might rise further yet.
Perhaps I shall one day sit upon the throne of all England. King Giedrich the drunken ass.
I'll raise a cup to that.
Look, you Saxon bedwetters, here is a real warrior.
Vili, Leave these poor boys alone. Their ears are too delicate for the filth you pour in.
Boys is right. This streak of cat piss is barely off his mother's tit. And the Essex boy has hands like a milkmaid.
Ha! Such fiendish ribaldry between you two. You laugh in the face of fear. Tweak old man Death's beard.
I will do my mother and my lord proud today, Eivor. The lord knows I've not been the best of sons.
Good to see your spirits high. Fight well, my friends, and we'll feast together in victory.
You soft-cheeked Anglo boys. Have you brought your mothers with you?
Tefter, it is good to see you.
I gave you my word. Besides, Alfred's faith is strict and he has no love for pagans.
You have changed much from that guard-whipped boy. That is good to see.
I was always him, but my faith was like a veil. I am glad you helped me lift it.
And now another education. You'll see how we Norse bards fight.
I am all a quiver with anticipation.
You soft-cheeked Anglo boys. Have you brought your mothers?
There you are, Raven.
Lufina, my old friend. And I see you have convinced your husband to stumble southwards.
I couldn't let her carve all the glory for herself. Lufina was just boasting of her heroics in Suthex.
She took the fort single-handed, while the rest of us sat back and sipped mead. You should have seen her.
I have come to make sure my warrior wife's enthusiasm for battle does not get her slaughtered.
Have you ever met a woman less in need of a guardian than me, Eivor?
You will have one nonetheless.
You, Eivor, a lot, my love.
I know.
Have you brought your mothers with you?
This last of...
Eivor! It's good to see you.
Erki and Stowe, I released you from your debt, and yet you came.
London is quiet enough, and Stowe here felt the sharp stab of conscience.
Could not let you down, Eivor. That's not what an honorable man does. So here I am, despite my reservations.
And you, Broda, I did not think you would be here either.
I have seen to my brother, sent him to Valhalla with grave goods. I am done with sorrow, Eivor. Now I am bloody angry.
My mother is worth 10 of your men.
I do not doubt. The debt will be...
Ah, Finir. You have come far at my call, old friend.
I've done all I can to help King Oswald find his feet. I leave East Anglia in good hands.
You do not plan to return, then?
No. When I heard of a mighty warrior in the west who brings terror to the Saxons, I came to join you. If you'll have me.
Once we have seen to Alfred, we will raise a horn. Not as allies, but as companions.
If drinking and feasting be in my future, I will follow you to hell.
I do not doubt. I have seen those strong Saxon men clucking round the hearth as you farmers play with your cocks.
Dear love, you have come again at my call.
I have, but this does not sit well with me, Eivor. This is a Christian feast, and the people here are not soldiers.
I come only for Alfred.
Innocents will die for your ambitions. I am your ally now, but after this, I must turn back to Mercia. I have much to repent.
So long as I do not lose your friendship, your oath will be fulfilled.
I do not doubt it. I have seen those strong Saxon names clucking round the hearth as you farmers.
The last vestiges of Ragnar's legacy.
Eivor, you made it unscathed.
Let us speak of our plan to take Chippenham. Let us plan our approach. But whatever happens, Alfred is mine.
They are not expecting us. We should not meet much resistance on the way.
Then quietly through the fields. It will already be too late once they see us.
Your young Saxons can be our eyes to the west. Better to keep their soft hands away from the conflict.
My scouts reported that a few nobles have arrived for the festivities already.
Good. If we capture the Thanes, there will be no danger when I confront Alfred.
And we could persuade them to support a new king of Wessex. I will subdue the lords.
Take Deolaf and Tefter with you. They could prove useful in convincing the Thanes. Rodin, take Erki and Stowe and capture the garrison. Make quick work of any Saxons that dare cross into the village.
Gladly, Eivor.
We each know our parts. May they blunt their swords against our might.
Tonight, Wessex's last resistance will crumble.
I follow you, Eivor.
And I.
Be ravening wolves and croaking ravens. Stand firm, your axe arms strong, and together, we will win this final battle. And remember, Alfred is mine. Soma, with me. Everyone else, go quickly to the village. Advance. Be on the lookout for any stray guards. Get to the village and wait for my signal.
I shouldn't be seen here. A hood should work.
Let's smoke the rat out of his guard's house!
Let's see, Sunan.
Alfred! Face me, and I will spare the last of Wessex my torch!
Did you think my king would turn his back on you, Eivor, when your knife is smeared with the blood of Wareham?
Stand aside, Goodwin. I come for Alfred.
Alfred is long gone, and this good Christian feast, a cup of honey wine, to trap some wasps.
Where is he?
Calling his allies to his side. All those who wish to see Wessex under one god. You cannot win England with your sorry crew of deluded farmers and godless fools.
At least I wouldn't leave them to die as I scurried through the corn husks like a rat.
You have no understanding of duty, the loyalty I freely give. His plan for England, for the world, is worth the cost of my life.
Then sing your tuneless hymns.
Come, raven feeder. Do your worst. I have no fear of death, for this battle is only the beginning.
Only darkness will come to claim you.
You are beaten, Goodwin.
Beaten? No, not so. By my death, my lord may live.
Alfred used you, fool. He threw you in my path. For what? He only delays what is inevitable.
Kill me then. It makes no odds. For here you stand, bloody and breathless, no closer to my king, no closer to his throne. This island will never be your home, Eivor. You will not subdue her with vicious force or win her with cocksure words. We Saxons will always stand firm, shoulder by shoulder against thieves and tyrants whose envious eyes fall upon England.
No. I will use you as you used me. A few hours in the company of my men, and you will lead us to your Sparrow King.
That I cannot allow.
I need you fighting with the rest!
These men will not surrender! And one little cockflog barricaded himself behind that door there!
I will find a way in! Good work, Guthrum. I hope the rest have fared as well. I'll find them. Unwald! Come, get up! This is no time for weep wailing!
I cannot. And there is a blackness closing in around my eyes. It frightens me.
Forgive me, Unwald. I should have been quicker.
No.
Hunwald, listen to me. You survived the Battle of Bottleston. Do not let this scratch best you now.
I'm so cold. Has winter come so soon?
You will warm yourself with mead and dancing yet, my friend.
Perhaps not, Eivor. It may be I will sit beside my father soon. Will he be proud of me?
He will pull you to his breast. Sob bright words of welcome and until you know man ever had a worthier son.
I am glad to have known you, Eivor. My truest.
Nothing more you could have.
I need to see if Broda has taken the garrison.
Make sure the garrison stays under our control. I need to help the others. Huh?
righteousness!
Stand true! God protects us on his day of feasts!
God damn you!
These Danes defy our God and King!
I'll have your guts out!
Rout us, interlopers! Not on this Christ mass!
The last of the Saxons are fleeing! The battle is won! That's it! They're fleeing!
You...
Routed! The city is ours! Wessex will follow!
Guthrum Jarl, we are not without losses. Some of them grave.
Their king is fled, his patsy struck down. Defeat rings loud in their ears, and I will be their lord before the spring is here.
Guthrum, hear me. Soma is... she's gone.
Soma? Dead? She has gone to the endless feast, and is the better for it.
Many fought for us and died. They deserve peace.
Are you ready to honor them?
Yes, there's nothing more to say.
Time to send our friends to their great reward. Will you do the honors?
Nothing awaits them. They lived, they died, and now their bodies will burn to cinders. Their saga ends here.
Well, do not share that with them.
Victory is ours, but it came at a great cost. Soma Jarlskona, who stood at Guthrum's right hand, she will live on in our memories from now to the end of days. And to Hjor, warrior, husband, and a friend, he made the ultimate sacrifice. I here repay it. And to Hunwald, whose kind heart has now led him to his father's side. May his God welcome him with open arms. Let us send them on their way. All our beloved dead, our fallen warriors, and speed them to their end.
Guthrum.
When the Reeve died, did he take comfort in knowing he would soon see his god?
He was strangely peaceful in the end, as if death meant nothing.
We stumble through our years, ravenous, grasping, spilling blood, stealing gold, and it is never enough. This life is never enough. Would it not suit you to know there is something beyond all this? Not war and valor, but quiet and peace?
I think the afterlife men hope for is only a reflection of their regret in this life. All I wish for now is to live among the friends I've made. That is what counts.
Alfred made me swear fealty upon the cross of their god's son. He held such faith in it. A plain, unadorned thing. It burned between my fingers, as if I had pulled it from the fire. A feeling strange and powerful, but gone in an instant. I have not felt its like before.
What will you do now?
Whatever I must do. England is my final home, Eivor. And I will do what it takes to remain.
I should return to Swanborough and tell her of Hunwald's fate. Better the news comes from me than a stranger.
Good to see you. Eivor?
Swanborough, I...
No. Gods, no. Don't say it, please, Eivor. Don't say it.
I am sorry.
Oh! My own one. No! My poor swan! Oh, gods!
He fought bravely and turned the tide to secure a victory. Your dear Hunwald died a hero and will be so remembered.
Oh, gods. I know he would have fainted to hear such praise from your lips. Thank you, Eivor. Thank you.
He walks among warriors now.
Yes. The lucky man. I imagine he does.
I know words are poor salve for a wounded heart. I will leave you to mourn, and know that we are here for you, always, should you need us. Hamtunscire has fallen, and with it the kingdom of Wessex. But the cost was great, maybe too great for all we gained.
Rest then. You have earned it.
On the backs of so many. Time will tell if it was worth it.
done that before.
Survey the area, Sunan.
Archbishop never suspected my heresy. I kept secrets as I gathered believers. I appeared so pious my eyes bled for him. But I've never felt as much love for his god. Not like I do the old gods. The true gods. Our ancient creators.
Your life was a lie, you mean? You threw your honor into the ocean.
When I told the Archbishop my true belief, he was horrified. So I silenced him.
That silence comes for you now.
Between you and me, Eivor, always thought you'd be a good jarl.
About you and Bridget, when do you wish to be wed?
The sooner I can make her my wife, the happier I will be. But we are fine to wait until everything has settled here.
Enough waiting. Cool your forge and cover your anvil. Let's get you married.
Wonderful. Shall we gather everyone?
Gather your wife and your courage. I will bring the people together.
I am honored to stand before you, Gunnar, Bridget, on this bountiful day, to celebrate the strength of your bond and to see you wed. I am in witness of a love that inspires and empowers. I invite you now to speak your vows.
To you, my darling, Bridget, I offer this blade, forged in flames that burn as brightly as my heart does for you. A blade as sharp as your wit, as glinting as your beauty. May it sing through the air as sweetly as your voice meets my ears.
Dio, sed vidit carit siganar. Dun evam lucis, vuri vidadora hito ti in hariat.
And I, you, I give you my sword and my promise that I will stand at your side forever.
Hid vidi brdoid yo am future and heen. A disort hawoloch in hope, a premonition. On the mount of scrying a foresight, para toivi a sweeping adventure meeting tea. Tiur enoid val dim arall, a dyn a strong a bwyrdd i gi, ac fel as i ffys, mae'r calon yn hedfan dyr y ti.
Such poetry, oh dear, you make me cry, my love.
Let us hedfan efo'n gilydd, tro bywyd yn beyond.
I offer you this ring, and take yours in kind. I will wear it with pride and honor, warmed by the love of so perfect a lady.
And I gwisg of a Valcalon, adoration a feed and bith.
This is the greatest day of my life. Embrace me, my love.
With our couple now bonded in matrimony, now we drink. Landry, saw you looking a little lonely. Thought I might come and join you.
How nice. Are you enjoying yourself?
I am. I never thought I would see gruff old Gunnar so enraptured by woman.
Enraptured by anything, for that matter. He's a hard one to read, but I am pleased for him, and for this day of rest and respite. After everything, a few days of feasting will do the people some good. They need this.
They do.
Will you walk with me?
Anywhere. Lead on.
Something has been on my mind for some time. I am no seer, but I foresaw this day long ago. Not Gunnar's marriage, but our situation. Our success.
How do you mean our success?
I mean to say that I saw our settlement flourishing, through our victories in war and in diplomacy. And from the day we set out from Norway, I knew that you would make a fitter leader than Sigurd. It was never in his character to lead. It was always within yours.
I see.
Do you?
You might have warned me.
You would not have listened.
Fair.
I do hope you see it now, in all that you have done for us.
Randvi, you and the people here have done more for me than I could ever repay. I am honored by your faith in me, and your confidence.
As I am honored by your friendship.
And I by yours.
Eivor, I want you to know that Sigurd and I are... We are severing the bonds of our marriage. We share a love that is steadfast, and I have faith it will forever be so. But it is not the love of a wife and her husband. It was not an easy decision. But after we talked with honesty, we embraced more warmly than we have in a great while. I think we will be happy.
I hope so. And I am pleased for you.
I am pleased for myself. Sigurd's desires are bigger than any man or woman can offer. He longs for something more.
And what about you? What are you looking for?
I have all I need right here, with you. with our people.
I want to say, Randvi, I love you, and I have for some time. I did not pursue it, not wanting to betray my brother's trust. But that does not mean I did not desire it. Does that surprise you?
Gods, I worried you saw me as a woman starved for the affection of her husband. That it was loneliness driving me. But it was you, Eivor. Only you. Everything you are, everything you will become.
Randvi, without you, I would have lost my way 1,000 times.
I never told him outright, but I doubt he will be surprised. I think he may have suspected it even, some time ago.
If he suspected it, he never said anything.
He is more observant than I often give him credit for. I believe he sees us as we are, and as we hope to be. We can wait to tell him. Give it a few days, when the feasting is over and everything is settled.
Agreed. I have waited long enough for you, and you for me. What is another few days?
The blink of an eye. Shall we find our way back to the wedding? Bridget might give another speech. We must not miss that.
About that, I have not understood a single word of her since Gloucestershire.
Really? I find she speaks beautifully. With poetry, even.
Are you kidding?
Am I? Come, we should go.
It is a strange feeling, brother. Weddings are the beginning of something, but this feels like something of an end.
The first happy union in our home. We have matured into something greater. So yes, a beginning and an end, I think.
Volka, I want to thank you for all you've done for me. My visions have lessened of late, and I find it hard to explain how different I feel. Grounded, unified, at peace.
That is good to hear, Eivor. Very good to hear.
Alvis, I'm surprised you did not serenade the bride and groom with a verse or two.
Oh, I wished to, I did. But all that came to me were insults and jibes. Another time, I think.
Gunner, you old trout. You're a married man. Never thought I would see the day.
Nor did I. And not for lack of trying.
Bridget, I gift you a formal welcome to our clan and our family. You are a fine addition to Gunnar's life and to ours.
Dear Javier, I couldn't be more happy to see Boma. Hoping I would see Wash in a kiss me so that he is.
Yes, of course. As I say, it is wonderful to have you. I want to see the Alliance map. I have changed my mind. I should go.
I have something for you. A message. Quite strange.
Something for me. What is it?
A letter requesting your presence in the southwest, a village called Athelney.
Nothing strange about a summons for me, is there?
It is not the recipient I find strange. It is the sender. The letter is signed a poor fellow soldier of Christ.
Ah, our mysterious partner.
For a short time, I hoped it might be Bassem feeding us the names of these targets. He seemed the most likely man, for a time.
Only one way to discover the truth. Thank you, Hytham. I will take care of this. Nearing the Avon River at Athentune. This was where Alfred said the battle with Uther took place. Thunin, guide me.
All right there?
Yes, hello. I do not mean to intrude, but I am looking for someone.
And who would that be then?
I do not know exactly.
Well, that'd be why you ain't found him.
But you're free to pass the time just here if you like.
Thank you.
Soul cakes, love. Do you know soul cakes?
I do. I enjoy them.
They're small things, size of a lumpy fist, so they'll bake fast. Keep your eyes sharp.
And the butter, do I baste them?
No need, love. We leave the butter for meal time.
I look forward to it.
Right then. I'll leave you to this. If you need me, I'll be doing the washing up next door.
Quite a step down from your former work, Lord.
As their guest, I volunteer to help with the daily chores. They offer me a bed. I tend the cakes.
Do they not feel strange giving orders to their king? Or do they know?
That knowledge would benefit no one.
I read your message. You went through a great deal of trouble to obscure yourself as this poor soldier of Christ. As I remember, you even sent yourself one of these letters in Winchester. A clever touch.
The Order wanted me dead. I had to be careful.
You said you knew nothing about the Order then. Pled ignorance. But you knew everything. Their names. Their schemes.
Would you join me for a walk?
You look well, Eivor.
I am. Wars have ended, and my settlement thrives.
The wars have not ended. You have simply stopped fighting. But men are brewing plots in mead halls and bedrooms. You will see.
And how are you, Alfred? Getting used to the idea of being unremarkable?
I am well. Better than I expected. In this exile, I have found a somewhat nourishing peace. Each morning, I am awakened by the sun and growling cormorants. I bathe in the chilly water of the marsh. I eat from shrubs and drink from buckets. It is a good life. Simple. Blessed. I've never been so far west. I find it quite peaceful here. Calming.
I have traveled a long way to hear one name, Alfred. Who is the Order's Grand Magister?
Tell your shadowy friends that England is swept clean. Your work is done.
You?
Grand Magister was not a title I desired. It passed to me on the death of my brother. From my father before him. Defilers of God's majesty and grandeur. I was their master. And I loathed them. With Goodwin, I set a plan in motion to destroy the Order from within. But my troubles with the Danes delayed that plan.
But your trouble with this Dane is what led to their demise.
You are Norse, are you not?
You have a good ear.
I owe you my thanks, Eivor. For that, I give you this. The key to my study, that you may better understand the good you have done. With the Order all but destroyed, you have made room for a greater idea, one to take its place, a universal divine order, inspired by God for the betterment of man.
With a poor fellow soldier at its head.
You have saved England, whether or not that was your intent. Now let England save you.
England is no more, Lord. You are the last of her kings, and yet you have no kingdom.
Look around you. God's works are wondrous. They cannot be ignored, nor resisted. In time, all those who accept God will flourish, and all those who defy him will fall away. Should you remain in England, you too will one day be her subject.
Oh, bloody crumbs! The cakes are burnt! Where is that man? Young man, where have you gone?
Damn. That may have earned me a night of washing linens. I do not know if we shall meet again, Eivor. God willing, we will. As one lord to another, perhaps. I'm coming, my lady. I'm here.
Alfred gave me a key to unlock his study. Somewhere in Winchester.
Oh dear, look at them little balls of soot!
Please forgive me, I was lost in thought.
No matter, just let him cool and we'll begin again.
Direct me and I will obey.
Eivor, I want to thank you on behalf of myself and Bridget. Our wedding was the greatest day of my life, and it could never have gone so well without you.
Truly, Gunnar. It was my pleasure. I have to go. See you soon. them. The last of the Order's sigils. You will find King Alfred's among them.
King Alfred? Did our poor fellow soldier lead you to his hiding place?
He did, for they were one and the same. Our poor fellow soldier of Christ was the Grand Magister of the Order of the Ancients.
He turned on his own order. Fascinating.
Not turned so much as trampled. His devotion to Christ and what he calls a universal order set him against them from the start. With all sincerity, he loathed the title and the duty he had inherited and wished them destroyed.
Wonderful. With his abdication, the last stronghold of the Order has been dismantled. All that remain are scraps here and there. And you, Eivor. Now that you have seen our enemy and you understand our cause, I wonder if you would join us. Become a hidden one.
Was this your ultimate goal, Hytham? A trial by fire? It is a kind offer, but I do not believe we fight for quite the same cause. Your creed demands that you keep your triumphs hidden. I prefer my glory to be in plain view for all to see.
If I taught you our creed, if you spent time with it, it could open your mind to another view.
Another view is always welcome. But to live without celebrating one's glory and honor and achievements is not a life for me. But know this. I would give my life in a moment for those I love and who love me in return. All here. Including you, my friend.
I understand you well, Eivor. Very well indeed.
Study. What secrets has he kept hidden away?
Rantings and ravings, not unlike full-case delusions. Is there more to all this than I understand?